Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In this video, we're going to test out the different stabilizations inside of DaVinci Resolve 18, comparing the old way of stabilizing your footage with the new Gyro Camera Tracker, and that's what we're going to do in this video. So let's jump right to the test. So first off, here we have a test with the perspective, and this shot is done with a 14mm. It's a Samyang, and of course it's handheld, so we can see what we're doing. Here we have Similarity, and we can see how that looks. There's a bit of wobbling in the corners. If we go to Translation, we now can see that we are going to have some difficulties with the handheld movement. And here we have the camera Gyro Tracker. And even though this is not a perfect shot, it is dramatically better. And here we have a comparison side by side, camera gyro versus perspective. And here we go to camera gyro versus Similarity. And again, here it's gyro versus translation. And here we have all side by side, so you can kind of see what's going on here. And for the last test, I'm just going to show you how it actually works, so you can see how much it's actually doing if we take out the zoom in position in the cameras. And you can see that the camera gyro tracker is working very hard to keep the footage nice and steady. So if you have a Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera, 4K, 6K or 6K Pro, do use the camera gyro tracker if you want to stabilize your footage. It's going to look a lot better that way. So I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.